the hardest working man in show. In show business. They used to say it exactly like that too.
Yeah.
But you are, I mean, you just finished doing everything with Infectious Grooves and already you're recorded the Suicidal Tendencies album.
Yeah, got the new Suicidal coming out June 30th.
And was it like directly after, because you were on the road with Suicidal Tendencies opening up for Queensryche for a while, right? And then right after that you did Infectious Grooves?
We did the record right before we did the Queensryche tour, and then we didn't put it out till we finished the tour with Queensryche. So the Infectious came out in September. And then we did a first batch of demos. Infectious went out with Ozzy, came back, did another batch of demos, and then went in the studio in March, started doing the record.
So did you have any time just kind of to hang out? Or was it pretty much right after Infectious was on the road, you went back in the studio and did Suicidal Tendencies?
There's always time. You know, everybody's got time. It's just most people choose to waste it. So, you know, I keep it busy.
Is what you like doing recording and putting out records and touring?
I like making music, you know. It's cool to start off with something before you know what it's going to be, and then to hear it afterwards and stuff and go, yeah, that's pretty cool. Unfortunately, we've been in a situation afterwards, you go, yeah, it is cool, you know. Maybe one day we'll go, it ain't, but that's when we get out of it.
All right, we're going to talk to Mike, and I think you're going to let us hear a little bit about the new Suicidal Tendencies, which I haven't even heard yet, and everybody knows what a big Suicidal fan I am. But right now we're going to be playing a video from Faith No More. Here is Midlife Crisis. Everybody knows that I'm such a big fan of both bands, and we've got the new Suicidal Tendencies album cover, or what it's supposed to look like. The album's going to be called The Art of Rebellion.
Yes.
Very cool drawing. Explain the title a little bit. I mean, you can kind of figure it out, but...
That's one of those ones that has a lot of meaning, and our particular meaning is probably a little different than what people are, but you know, it's with everything, it's there's the art and there's the artiste involved with it, and it's the way people do things, and even things that are supposed to be spontaneous and stuff, often there's a preconceived, you know, calculation involved with it, and with everything you see, it's, you know, it's that whole thing of people fitting in and doing the wrong thing the right way, you know, and so it's kind of funny.
Now, I guess we're going to be able to listen to a little portion of Brand New Suicidal Tendencies?
Yeah, we're going to play a part of a... It's like starting from the middle of one of the songs, the first song on the record, a song called Can't Stop.
Can't Stop? Which is good, because
yes.
I've never even heard it either. So let's take a listen. Brand New Suicidal Tendencies.
I was scared. I am scared. I know it. But I'm not afraid to admit it. See, being scared, it don't bother me. It's just a feeling. I can deal with that. I know what it is, it's what I don't know, what I can't feel. That's what bothers me, that's what really scares me. See, right now I'm scared, really scared, cause I can't feel.
You scared?
Yes, very much. And so are your little brothers and sisters if you turn the lights off and play it to them.
Yeah, one thing I want to say about Suicidal Tendencies that I've always felt, and even some critics agree, that with your lyrics, there's always a couple sentences that they will take out and always, like when they're reviewing it, put in big print, like with the other one, you can put a bullet in my head, but you can't kill the words I've said, stuff like that. I mean, you've always got a lot of really powerful lyrics. Are there any certain sayings in this album that you think really stand out as being, you know, an important message from Suicidal?
Yeah, there's a lot of things, you know. It's also the fact of, you know, that what is said and what's going to mean to somebody else you don't have control over and stuff. And I think, and that's probably a good thing, you know, because sometimes the songs that were suicidal that have meant the most to people are people that had a record and 3 years later go, you know, man, I was tripping the other day. I played that song and I've had the record so long. And like, you know, they'll say a little background on something that's happened to them recently. And it's like, whoa, it just like totally had a different meaning and stuff.
Cool. Well, we're going to come back and talk to Mike Muir. And I got lots of questions to ask about the new Suicidal Tendencies, and especially when you're going to hit the road, and if you're going to be allowed to hit the road this time with Suicidal Tendencies, because I guess it was easier for Infectious Grooves. We're going to be back with Mike Muir right after this, so please stick around, won't you? There was a funkier version, kind of Suicidal Tendencies, right?
Well, a little bit. You know, it's a band, and we're going to continue on. Started working on our second record. Got two more videos coming out. Got one from the Encino Man soundtrack that we're on, and one more from the record, and you know, keeping it on and stuff. With Suicidal, I think the thing about the Infectious is actually people say, what's the similarity now with the new Suicidal? It's actually the effect of Infectious has made Suicidal go even further into another direction, a direction that we don't think anyone's really gone, and a direction that that we want to go in. Because I think music should be a situation when a new record comes out, people should sit there and not know whether they like it or not. They should sit there and be uncomfortable, and be uncomfortable for a number of reasons because they don't quite understand it. And I think the best music that's ever been, you know, when Jimi Hendrix's stuff first came out and stuff, and some of his guitar work, and, you know, there's certain records, it's like, whoa, they must have freaked the hell out of people. I wasn't around then, but you can just imagine. And I think that's what good music is when people don't know whether they like it or not, and it's not a situation where they see everybody else listening to it, so, oh, it's cool to like that, it's good. You know, I want it to be cool not to like it. And that's you know.
But you don't want too many people to be cool and not like it.
Yeah. I think I'd rather have it mean something to someone than people just to like it for the sake of, like, yeah, you know, scoring brownie points at school because you're in a suicidal.
Yeah, about meaning something. Your lyrics, to me, have always had some very powerful and important messages. And on the same token, have also been fun, like the song Lovely. Mm-hmm. And when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit about the lyrics on the new album. But right now, we're going to be playing a video.
A
very fun video. And I like how you sing the part that goes, boop. This is Suicidal Tendencies with You Can't Bring Me Down.
Not Betty Boop.
Infectious Grooves, and we're talking about the new Suicidal Tendencies album, which is called The Art of Rebellion, and comes out
June 30th.
June 30th, new Suicidal Tendencies. Now, we're speaking just before the break about how the last album had so many serious messages in it, as well as something kind of fun like Lovely. Mm-hmm. Is this album the same way?
I think it's a lot of our stuff, a lot of times people say, misinterpret as far as I'm concerned, they say it's angry, this and that. I think our music is a lot of times very emotional, and emotions have a lot of, there's a whole spectrum involved, and some people are very uncomfortable. You just say it's emotional, it's like, oh, you know, because they're very uncomfortable with the emotions that they have, and with suicidal, I think the thing is you have to learn to deal with emotions, good or bad, and that's how you appreciate your health, is when you're sick, because you realize what you have, and when you're healthy all the time, then it doesn't, you take it for granted, and people, a lot of times, it's the way they look at things, it's wrong. And with us, in a sense, we're more honest and stuff because it's easier to deal with things and you handle them a lot better rather than ignoring something. And, you know, you get cancer, you can ignore it, but it's not going to go away just because you don't deal with it because you don't get treatment. And a lot of times it's the same thing mentally besides physically. If you have a mental problem, you don't deal with it, it doesn't go away. It just gets worse, and eventually it'll have the same thing. It'll kill you in your mind or, you know, physically and stuff. So, we don't avoid things and stuff. And I think this record's a very emotional record. I think it's a very powerful record. And I think that's a great thing.
Now, there's a couple problems that you had with Suicidal Tendencies that you didn't have with Infectious. Was Infectious Grooves was allowed to play a lot of places, and I know that Suicidal Tendencies in the past, especially in Los Angeles, weren't really allowed to play. Do you think you're going to reach that problem again? Or unjust reasons, I might
add. Last Suicidal, we played at Irvine Meadows and stuff, so... which is one of the, you know, biggest venues, yeah. And stuff. And with Infectious, we tried to play at the Civic, and they said no. And so we went to Universal Amphitheater, which is bigger anyhow, you know. So I think it's a situation, you get to the point where when you can do so many people, it doesn't matter anymore. There's people that can't stop it, and it's ridiculous. We've done two shows now in Southern California where, you know, chaos was predicted, nothing happened, and you can't just say, well, there's going to be problems. You can't do a show because there might be problems. And we've done two shows now that there hasn't been any problems,
right.
And, you know, that are, you know, big venues and stuff. So we'll see what happens. And we're not going to go. We're going to do the Aussie tour starting in August, and we're doing a couple of dates before. And so we're not really going to do a headlining thing, and don't really know what we're going to do. We're going to take it as it goes, and that's the best thing, rather than say, yeah, we're going to be on the road for 18 months.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to do what we should do and what's the right situation and stuff. So.
Well, thanks for stopping by, and I'm sure that once I heard the record, I'll tell you all about it. It comes out June 30th. It's called The Art of Rebellion, Suicidal Tendencies. Thanks again for stopping by, Mike. Always a pleasure. You're always welcome here. And right now, I'll play a video that I know that you are extremely influenced by, right?
Yes, very much so.
Well, you can lead into it then.
This, I gotta do her. Lead to Spinal Tap, the majesty of rock.
Very good.